University. Unfortunately, my research field is advanced fusion reactor engineering, so there is no relationship to the tsunami effect. But the, my background is nuclear engineering, so that is why I was chair's committee to make a guideline. So let me introduce the background of this activity. On the basis of the fact of the Fukushima accident caused by large tsunami attack, the Japan Society of Marine Technology has organized a special committee to develop a guideline for assessing a large tsunami countermeasures in Japanese nuclear power plant. So in this presentation, I would like to report the result on the assessment of the large tsunami countermeasures conducted at Shimane nuclear power plant in the west part of the main island of Japan as one example from the viewpoint of the guideline developed by the committee. So before showing you the guideline, I would like to show you some of the review of Fukushima accident. So this is the this is a old data, but there is no difference between now. So here we are now in Sendai, and Onagawa power plant is located here, and also here is a Higashidori nuclear power plant here, and Fukushima Daiichi means number one site are located here, and Daini is number two is here, and also we have a Tokai nuclear power plant here. I think you know well, in the Tokai unit, the 6 meter height tsunami attacked the power plant. But fortunately, Ibaraki Prefecture pointed out that there is some possibility that the 6 meter high tsunami maybe attack this area. So in this power plant, they built it a kind of the water barrier for the emergency diesel generator. So they have three generators, and two of three were covered by the wall, and the last one was under construction. Okay, so end of the March, they finished all construction, but the earthquake attacked March 11th. So the third emergency diesel generator was flooded, so that it was not work. It did not work, but two emergency diesel generator worked well. So in Tokai nuclear power plant, they don't have any problem. Okay. On the other hand, in the Onagawa area, some of the emergency diesel generator was flooded. I will explain later. And here we have the Fukushima Daiichi site. There are six nuclear power plant, and also Fukushima Daini, there are four nuclear power plant. So I think you know, but let me give a brief explain about the earthquake. Okay, thank you very much. The nuclear power plants are located here, and the acceleration at the Fukushima Daiichi Unit 2, the horizontal acceleration is 550 gauss, and the vertical about 300 gauss. So it is a very large earthquake, and the I was in Sendai at that time, but the duration of earthquake is very, very long. Is that 3 minutes? 3 minutes. 3 minutes, I have to feel the unstable condition. Okay, and the, this is the earthquake size. In Fukushima Daiichi, the horizontal is about 500, and the maximum response acceleration for the in the design was about 400, something like that. So Fukushima number unit 2, 3, and unit 5, they experienced a large earthquake than expected. But now in the Congress report about the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant, they say in unit one, there is some possibility that the small rocker occurred. Rocker means a loss of coolant accident occurred. But that is a very unfair report because they used just one result to say that the leakage occurred due to the earthquake. That is that is like this. JNS is was JNS calculated that the pressure change in the reactor unit one does not change so much if we have small leakage. We don't have leakage, okay, the pressure changes like this. If we have leakage, pressure does not, pressure history does not change so much. So that means there is some possibility that we have the leakage in the unit one. But JNS also shows that the if we have the leakage, the pressure inside the container will increase so much because the hot water leaked. That means we will have the steam inside the container, but the pressure does not change. So that means we don't have the leakage from the piping due to the earthquake. But they ignore the last result, and they say, okay, there is some possibility that we have some of the leakage from the piping just to the earthquake. So please forget the Congress report, okay? It is a very unfair report. And also in unit five, also the acceleration is much higher than the than expected in the design. But fortunately, unit five and unit six survived. So we can see inside the unit five and there is no damage due to the earthquake. Okay, so that means other unit, especially unit one, which the acceleration, whose acceleration is less than the design base. So maybe this one is works well. So in the nuclear power plant, maybe some of knows very well, but most of people doesn't know about the nuclear power plant because all people are working for tsunami. So I would like to show briefly what happened when the normal shutdown. So here is a reactor vessel. And after shutdown, we have to remove the residual heat because the nuclear fuel has always generating the heat after shutdown. So this heat is removed, this residual heat removal system. So water goes like this, and here we have the heat exchanger, and the heat is put into the seawater. So in the before the earthquake, people just concerned about the tsunami. Tsunami ebi, what should I say? Maybe, yeah, this one is okay. This is a tsunami ebi because If tsunami attack the nuclear power plant, we will have tsunami AB. That means water goes out this way. So people say, okay, well, now you don't have any heat sink to put the energy coming from the reactor. But usually water C again come back to this area. So this is Onagawa power plant. They prepare this kind of a system. So in case of EBI, the water remains here, so we can perform heat exchange using this water. Okay, so they made a hole here in order to check the sea surface. Okay, because if sea surface is becoming low, then okay, we have to prepare something about against the AB. But this time, tsunami height is very high, so the water goes up here like a fountain, and then this water invades into reactor building. So if we don't make any hole here, then Onagawa reactor was not affected. But due to the hole here, the water comes here and then invade into reactor building. So in this in Onagawa, one of emergency diesel generator was flooded, as Professor Imagawa Imamura-sensei showed. Okay. And also, the site level is about 15 meters, but just after the earthquake, the ground is go down 1 meter. So as also Imamura-sensei said, that 1 meter is going down. So the after the earthquake, the height is about 14 meter, and tsunami level was 30 meter. So we have the just 80 centimeter margin to going the this flood go this way. On the other hand, in Fukushima area, we have the big problem. This is the Fukushima Daiichi number one site. The site level is about 4 meters above the sea surface. And here we have the heat exchanger pump for heat exchanger, and also we have the pump for diesel generator. So the height of tsunami is about 50 meters in this area. According to TEPCO explanation, this height is generated by superimpose of three kind of tsunami. One tsunami is almost 5 meter height, and we have three waves. And in the Fukushima number one area, the phase is almost same, so the peak is imposed, so 15 meter. On the other hand, in the Fukushima number two area, also there are existed three waves, but two of three were superimposed. That means the phase is same, so the peak, on the same time the peak comes, so 10 meter tsunami occurred in this area, but third one is a little bit delay, so the maximum was 10 meter. But in Fukushima Daiichi area, just as all three tsunami came in the same time, simultaneously, so the height becomes 50 meter. This is a typical explanation. So unfortunately, now we cannot believe everything Fat Tepco said. So we are waiting for other results, especially Imamura Sensei's result is very important to ensure what happened in the Fukushima area. And due to this tsunami, the water invaded into the turbine building and reactor building. So in the Fukushima number one site. There are six reactors, and five of six are a Mark I type reactor. That is a small type reactor. So that means reactor size is very small. That means reactor building is almost also small. So that means we don't have a big space around the corner. So they put emergency diesel system or other things inside the turbine building. But in the Mark II type, that means unit 6 in Fukushima Daiichi and four reactors in Fukushima number two site, they are Mark II type reactor. That means the reactor core is a little bit larger than that of Mark I. So that means we have the big space in the corner of the building. So we can put the emergency system, other things inside the reactor building. So this building is a little bit tougher than this turbine building. So, and also, this was just a usual shutter. So there is no structure. That means water goes into directly into the turbine building. So in Fukushima Daiichi site, I think two TEPCO persons were drowned to die in the turbine building. Okay. And in this area, we have a lot of emergency systems. So all systems were shut down after the tsunami attack. So maybe you can see this. Okay, this is the Fukushima Daiichi and Daini. This blue area is the area where water invaded. And also, here we have the unit 5 and 6. In unit 1, 2, 3 are operating at the time, and 4 is not operated at the time. Okay, maybe you can see this kind of figure many times. Okay, where is the car? Yeah, here is a car, but the tsunami goes up this area. So about this tank was under the water now. So you can see how the tsunami was terrible. And the sea pump area is a kind of mess. And also unit 5 and 6, also we have a big problem. Okay, let me move to this one. So this is the status of unit 1 to 6 in the Fukushima number 1 site. Unit 1 is operating, unit 3 operating. And the emergency diesel generator did not work. Also DC battery did not work. So that means isolation condenser system did not work. I will show you something about this. Also in unit 2, same thing happened, but fortunately battery sometime okay. And in unit 2, 4, 6 has the emergency diesel generator, which is cooled by air. So these three emergency diesel generator worked, but switching board is located inside a turbine building. That means we cannot provide electric power into the nuclear power plant unit 1, 2, 3, 4. And unit 6, this is a Mark II type, and also the elevation is a little bit higher than other four reactors. This unit worked, cannot affect it so much by tsunami attack. So the emergency diesel generator worked, just one generator worked. So, and unit 5 is also located at a higher elevator, so we can put some electric power into unit 5. So using just one emergency diesel generator, electric power is supplied to unit 5 and unit 6. So both can goes down, go to cool down, so no problem occurred. Okay. And this is the isolation condenser system equipped in the unit 1. This is a reactor, and if we don't have other cooling system, we have to use this isolation condenser system. Here is the tank, just we put some water here, and this is a reactor, and this is a heat exchanger. So usually this is located at a higher level, and due to the natural convection, the water goes this way or goes this way. I'm sorry, the line is missing here. Okay. So this is the natural convection system, so we don't need any power. But unfortunately, we have the valve here, two valves here. The usually one valve is closed because when we have some accident, we have to isolate the reactor. This is a basic principle. So if we happen something, valves are closed automatically. So in the usual procedure, at first we consider about the lack of electric power coming from emergency diesel generator because of run out of the oil. Okay, then we have the DC battery, so we can control something. But in the tsunami accident, everything was down. Simultaneously. So we at that time they cannot do anything because they lost all power, not AC but also DC power. So that is why they cannot do anything. Okay, but this is a kind of pity. After the 911, United States NRC asked all power plant in the United States to prepare something. Even if they lost DC power, they should operate, they should make some procedure to operate this system. This was issued 2006, about 5 years ago, the accident. But this was for the countermeasure for terrorist attack. So that is why they cannot open, show the content to other country. But there is, I heard that some of Japanese government people listened to the explanation done by NRC of the United States, but they ignored maybe at that time. So if they say something, okay, even if we don't have any DC power, okay, you should try to make some process to operate this system. If we have this system, we can avoid the Fukushima accident. Because after the tsunami attacked, unit two, in the unit two, they were prepared some power supply from the car means electric power car. Okay, so every line was already settled up at that time, and just they want to provide electric power to unit two. The unit one has a hydrogen explosion, had a hydrogen explosion. So everything is blown out. So they restart again everything, and also the background of radioactivity increases, so they cannot do anything for unit two. Then also unit three. So then we have the hydrogen explosion in unit three and unit three. And unit four is just the hydrogen coming to from unit three. The unit four was exploded by hydrogen explosion. So if this IC system could have worked, we could have avoided this tragedy. Okay. So this is the how much the radioactivity are released from the nuclear power plant. Of course, there is some difference between by nuclear and industrial safety agency of Japanese government and the this is a nuclear safety commission of Japanese government. There is a little bit difference, but almost one tenth of the radioactivity released by in the Chernobyl accident. And also, there is a big difference between Chernobyl accident and Fukushima accident. In Chernobyl accident, the nuclear fuel itself was exploded due to the steam explosion. But in the Fukushima area, mainly the released material were cesium, strontium, and iodine, whose evaporation temperature is lower, relatively lower. So the fuel itself is still inside the nuclear power plant, but we don't know where the real location of the nuclear fuel is located in the nuclear power plant, because there is core melted, so some part goes through down, and it is very difficult to identify where the fuel is located. Okay, and this is a Mark II type sono problem. And now you know well, we have TEPCO prepared circulating system. Just they put the water, and the water goes this way, and the they use some filter and go back again. So this is a kind of the loop. So but unfortunately, it is very difficult to reduce the total amount of water circulation, because some water invade into reactor from the around area. So due to the some head of the underground water, what should I say? Underground water. Okay. Some of underwater ground invade into this area. So, okay, it is very difficult to check how much now evaporating in this area or something like that. So, they are now using this kind of cooling system. Okay. So, let me back to the assessment. Okay, so from the experience of the large tsunami attack, this is my I believe that nuclear power plants were not affected so much by earthquake itself, but the tsunami is fatal for nuclear power plant. Okay, so we started this committee in order to check whether or not large tsunami countermeasure carried out after 311 is sufficient. This is which is required by NISA after the Fukushima accident, because NISA at that time required just you should prepare fire car or some pump or other electric power or something like that. But it is very difficult for me to say, okay, now all nuclear power plant is safe if the 15 height tsunami attack the power plant. So we started this kind of activity in order to explain the people around the nuclear power plant or local government, okay, now it's safe. So we started this one, and you see, here, this is a member of the committee. There are two chairmen. This is me, and other chairman is Professor Narabayashi of Hokkaido University. He was a very busy guy because every day I saw him on TV, because he was working at Toshiba company to design the nuclear power plant. He knows many things about the nuclear power plant itself. So he is always going to the TV studio. So that is why we put the two chairmen. And if one chairman is absent from the committee, okay, other chairman organize the committee, and the another chairman cannot change any result if you absent from the committee. So we take this kind of style. And okay, from Tohoku University, Professor Takagi also attended as the committee member. So, so from May 20th, 2011, the committee meeting was held every week, and its secretary meeting was also held 3 days before the committee meeting. That means meeting was held twice a week in Tokyo. So in this semester, I have four lectures. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. So Monday and Friday, I went to Tokyo, and other 3 days, I was in Tokyo University to make lectures. So it was very busy day at that time. And on July 7th, 2011, this guideline was approved at the committee. And also, we have already checked all nuclear power plant except TEPCO one, TEPCO's nuclear plant. And okay, what they are doing is okay. And we plan to start who will go to this site to explain how the countermeasure works well, will work well, so you don't worry about tsunami or something like that. But unfortunately, July 5th, 2011, previous Prime Minister Khan, Mr. Khan, referred to stress tests in Europe. So just 2 days before we finished everything, this crazy Prime Minister said something about the stress test. So in the last meeting, as a chairman, I told committee member who is a spy coming from the cabinet. Okay, just before 2 days, they started say something like that. So this committee was held morning in Friday. So afternoon, I went to NISA, Nuclear and Industrial Safety Agency, to give the this book. This is a guideline for evaluation of the tsunami treatment.
And also, I left a result of evaluation for all nuclear power plants in Japan. But this is, unfortunately, this is a kind of the official requirement. So all electrical companies say, okay, don't open the result. Because if there is some difference between that our evaluation and governmental evaluation, okay, people against the nuclear plant, power plant say, okay, you are saying lie, or something like that. So they are afraid that kind of thing. So, okay, so I asked NISA people not to make any copy of the result, but I forgot to taking the material with me, okay? So you can see this material, but don't distribute, okay? Then the top guy say, okay. And they started the their evaluation using our result. So purpose of the scope is like this. Purpose of this guy is to propose assessment method to confirm that tsunami countermeasure taken by Japanese power plant are appreciated to cool down the nuclear power plant after tsunami attack and so on. And we are considering about the operating BWS and PWS. So we eliminated the fast breeding reactor. And also, as an event, we consider beyond DBA event triggered by large tsunami induced by earthquake, focusing on cooling of the reactor and spent fuel storage pool. And also, in order to ensure electric power supply and ultimate heat sink, which are essential for the stable cooling condition after a large tsunami attack, the following are evaluated: preparedness of equipment or facilities against a large tsunami and scenarios of beyond DBA event. DBA means a design basis accident induced by large tsunami, including training and exercise for emergency management. This electric power and heat sink, I mean the water is very important, and also information is also important. Because I experienced this earthquake when I was in Sendai to teaching my student who want to go to TEPCO. Okay. So, and he's not so good student. So the lecture is, it took some 1 hour to teach him. So I was in a very large room. So due to the after earthquake, I don't injured. I was not injured. But if I return to my room, maybe some books come to me, and maybe I was injured. So I recommended him to Tohoku Electric Company, not Tokyo Electric Company, and he is now working at the Tohoku Company. But at that time, my wife prepared one thing. Okay, in my housing, also electric power goes out, and also we cannot use water or everything. But she filled a bathtub with water because some water remains inside the piping. Okay, then the bathtub is filled with water. This is very important because we can use that water. Okay, and also we don't have electricity. That is a problem. So my wife cannot do anything, but okay, why don't you use radio? Okay, you can get information. So we can get the information through radio. So radio and water, but we don't have electric power. Okay, so, and electric power returned to my house maybe 3 or 4 days later. Then everything works well. So electric power is very important, and also water is very essential. This is a save to just housing or nuclear power plant, it's the same thing. Also, information is very important. So let me skip something. And when the tsunami attack, flooding of inside or the equipment, we should consider this kind of thing. So seawater comes here. Here is a pump, seawater pump. This one is usually flooded, so we cannot use this one. And also, that means we cannot use the usual residual heat removal system because this pump does not work. So this situation happened in Fukushima number 2, Daini site, because most of the pump were flooded. Of course, they are located in front of the shore. Okay. But fortunately, in number 2 site, electrical power coming from other power plant worked. Okay, so that means they can use many water inside the site. Just they can open the valve or they can start up the pump, everything. Okay, so Fukushima number 2 site, they can go to cool down of reactor. Because this reactor was, what should I say? Let me see. This is a Mark II type, and also TEPCO has the Kashiwazaki area. They have also 7 reactors. 5 of 7 are Mark II type, and 2 of 7 are advanced BW type. And they have the this reactor was also shut down due to earthquake happened in this area. So. But some of them worked well, so they bring the water pump from this area to Fukushima area after the earthquake, 3 days after earthquake, and then they replace the seawater pump, and then they can put the heat generated inside the reactor to seawater. So. All nuclear power plant can stand without seawater almost 1 week if we have the electric power. Okay, so now, NISA asked all plant to prepare this kind of fire truck or other high voltage power through power supplying cars or keeping water supply function by supplying electricity and also prepare spare pump or cleaning. So also, this is a fire truck and waterproof building. Just they put very tough doors in front of the building. So last May, I visited Shimane nuclear power plant located here. So I will show you what they are doing now. And the they are trying to make countermeasures against the 50 meter height tsunami in the Japanese seaside. Maybe Professor Imamura Sensei, crazy height, but okay, they prepare this kind of thing. And what they are doing is water watertight doors, waterproof barriers, power supply vehicles, gas turbine generators, portable pump system, backup seawater pump, and countermeasures against pump flooding, backup seawater pump, and enhancement of breakwaters and others. Everything is on the website. And also they made a water barrier in front of the nuclear power plant. So, okay. They made a 15 meter height sea barrier in front of the reactor area. So it's very high, and also they make put waterproof doors everywhere, and also power supply vehicles here, and also backup water sea pump is located here, and also I think they have a gas turbine generator here. So I proposed Tohoku Electric Company, if you prepare this kind of the system, why don't you supply this electricity to the local area if other system shut down? Because, okay, they can provide electric power, this, of course, the nuclear power plant, but if they have some other electric power, they should provide this power to the people living around the nuclear power plant. Then they get the information, because they can see TV or they can use a cell phone or something like that. So, okay, they, but this time system is not good in from the viewpoint of cost. So they say, okay, they will consider, but I don't know the result, but I think Tohoku Electric Company tried to do something like that. Also, mayor of that kind of area asked Tohoku Electric Company, never power off anytime in this area, okay? So this is very important for the people living around the nuclear power plant. So this is a kind of the waterproof, water protect systems. And for example, here they have the power supply vehicles, and they make a training. And this is a portable pump for the heat exchanger of diesel generator. And also they prepare the pumps, and they making some the barrier. And this is the beyond this wall, there is there exists a sea, and this height is 50 meter. I visited this area also, very high wall. And after tsunami, if tsunami goes over this area, then we can make a kind of the small pond, lake. Okay, then we have the sea water in this area, so we can put a portable pump to heat exchange. Okay, so I proposed when I visited this power plant, and they tried to consider, because tsunami attacks so many times, so it is very difficult to the portable pump into the sea water outside the nuclear plant site, because next attack will destroy that kind of system. But if inside the nuclear power plant we have the some water heat sink, then it's okay. So this is a kind of guideline. Sorry, I cannot distribute my presentation because the Japanese Society of Meteorology issued this book. Everything is inside this book, and the price is 100 euro per book. Very expensive. No, 100 euro. So I cannot distribute my talk. Otherwise, maybe branch chairman Takagi sensei will make claim. Okay. Then what we did is summarized here. For this is for example of power supply system. This is the emergency diesel generator, or this is for example heat exchanger system for diesel generator, or and so on. This is a DC power supply, and so on. So if we have the tsunami attack about 5.7 meter, everything works here, but if the 10.7 meter, we can use this diesel generator itself okay, but heat exchanger system is not available, so we cannot use this system. So then we have to use other system, and this is the final evaluation. Here, we have the big earthquake here, and then offsite power we cannot available usually. The emergency diesel generator works well, but tsunami attacks, okay, we cannot use this emergency diesel generator, so we have to use DC battery here. Then, 8 hours, this DC battery will run out, so we cannot do any power supply inside the nuclear power plant. This is before the application of countermeasure. So, before the earthquake, if the large tsunami attacks, all nuclear power plant cannot stand for the tsunami, large tsunami. But this is for the Mark II type, so we can expect DC battery here. But in the unit one of Fukushima number one site, also DC battery does not work due to the tsunami because it was located in the turbine building. So now after the countermeasure, here we have the DC battery here. But now we have the power supply car or something other things. So now here we can use the power supply car. We can get the power. That means we can use other cooling system because we can provide electric power. So the blue line is in standby and green was working, operating. So that means we have the very good system. So this is for the water injection type cooling system. And also we can use the system if we have the electric power. So but you can see here, DC battery is the only way we can supply the electric power to the nuclear power plant. So this is a weak point. So if we do this kind of thing, okay, if I'm a terrorist, okay, okay, DC battery is a key system. Okay, if we, at first we cut off-site power just using some of the bomb, small bomb, and then we break the seaside water pump, and then we cut the battery, then nuclear power plant cannot do anything. So United States NRC required all nuclear power plant to do something without DC battery in order to make some treatment due to the terrorist attack. And also, if we have the other air cooling system or something like that, then we don't have to use battery now. Of course, you use battery, but also we can use this one. Also, off-site power, if we have a good power, like gas turbine generation system, just upside the nuclear power plant, usually off-site power usually easily used. Okay, so that means we have there many ways to cool down the nuclear reactor core. So this is a summary of the assessment. Tsunami countermeasures of Shimane nuclear power plant are reasonable and contribute to the enhancement of the reliability and safety of the power of the plant against a tsunami. So at first, before the treatment, maximum tsunami height is about 5 meters, but now 15 meters is okay, no problem. This is our result according to our guideline. Thank you for your attention.